Our departure time is 2300. Get your bird started and I'll meet you at the runway.
Colt 1-1, Colt 1-2, radio check.
1, copy.
Tonight, you'll be using two versions of the AGM-65 Maverick missile. The Maverick is a precise, guided, standoff missile. It optimizes target destruction and aircraft survivability. It is a fire-and-forget missile, so once launched, you can immediately break off your attack and get out of Dodge. Successful Maverick deployment requires thorough mission planning. There are many factors that can influence an attack, including target type, weather, and threats. Clouds, smoke, and fog can cause a Maverick to lose track. They also reduce shadows and target area heating, making it difficult to get a lock on the target. Low cloud cover may force you to employ from a lower altitude, putting you in the weapon engagement zone for any threats. The hard deck on the range will be 500 feet AGL. This is the foul line, and you will fail this PO if you go below this altitude. And above all, make sure you positively ID the targets. We don't want to kill any friendlies today.
Pull up! Pull up! Altitude! Altitude!
Cobaletti, Colt, 1-1. Request taxi to runway.
Colt, 1-1. Cobaletti, clear to taxi to runway 2-5.
1, rolling. Cabaletti, Colt, 1-1, request takeoff.
Colt, 1-1, Cabaletti, you are cleared for takeoff and ready. Climb 300 at QFE 29.86.
Performance check starts now. Colt 1-1, Colt 1-2, fly heading 245, Angels 8, and maintain an appropriate speed.
Wheels up.
Hard deck limit is in effect. Do not go below Angels 5 unless the restriction is terminated. Approaching Angels 8. Level out and maintain appropriate speed. Good. Maintain 245, Angels 8, and appropriate speed. Use of the autopilot is authorized. Let's review the mission profile. Threat level is low, so this will be a high, low, high altitude profile. Your first target is at waypoint 5. The target is a mobile command post and only use the AGM-65D on this target. Your second target will be at waypoint 6. Use the AGM-65H on this target. Your third target will be at waypoint 7. Target the fuel truck only. You can use either AGM type on this target. Your last target will be a moving convoy near waypoint 8. Target the tanks only with your remaining AGMs. You are permitted to finish any remaining targets using gun strafing. Let's review the air-to-ground training rules. Perform all delivery passes, including jettison passes, whether hot or dry, using live ordnance delivery parameters to include fuse arming, safe escape, safe separation, and flight deconfliction considerations. Avoid populated areas to the maximum extent possible when carrying externally loaded, heavyweight, inert, or externally internally loaded live ordnance. Prior to first release when carrying expendable ordnance, live, inert, or training, final switch configuration for weapon release will not be accomplished until the aircraft is in such a position that any accidental release will be contained within the range. Do not conduct simulated attacks against off-range or manned targets with the internally externally loaded live ordnance or externally loaded heavyweight inert ordnance. This restriction does not apply to 20 or 30 millimeter ammunition, BDU-33s, 2.7 inch TP and SP rockets, or non-expendable training assets. The use of combat laser mode of laser designator is restricted to laser certified ranges. All air-to-surface laser operation on range will be in accordance with range planning and operations and local range procedures. Knock it off can be called by anyone and all must acknowledge. If you see it first, call it. This could be due to a training rule violation, loss of SA, out-of-control flight, radio failure, bingo fuel, or any other dangerous situation. Nordo aircraft will rock his wings to indicate the radio failure. Colt 1-1, Colt 1-2. Turn right to 330, maintain Angels 8 and an appropriate speed. Since we will be maneuvering, we will do a G awareness test shortly after passing waypoint 2. Brevity code is G warm. This is important in assessing your G proficiency and getting back your timing and execution of the anti-G straining maneuver. Checking G suit and combat edge connections and operation. Recalibrating how you apply on onset and control at peak level aircraft G. Providing an exposure to the cardiovascular system to activate its reflex response to a drop in blood pressure. A maneuver of 3 to 5G for about 10 seconds is required to fully develop this reflex response. The maneuver is not performed in order to test how many G you can pull that day. Don't G-lock on the G-awareness turn. Remember your anti-G straining maneuver. Anticipate the G. Simultaneously tense all lower body muscles, legs, butt, and abdominal muscles. Deep breath with forced exhalation against a closed airway. Quick breath every 3 seconds, once at peak G. Minimize communications. Don't relax until the G is unloaded. Colt 1-1, Colt 1-2. Turn right to heading 065 and maintain Angels 8. Colt 1. Excel, G warm. Colt 1, G warm, 90 left. Go. Colt 1, G warm, 90 right, go. Colt 1, fence in. Colt 1, 2, fenced in, fuel, 4-3. SIF range control, Colt 1, 2. Request clearance for Colt 1, flight of 2 A-10s west of entry alpha. We have 3 AGM-65Ds, 3 AGM-65Hs, 2 AIM-9s, and 2,000 rounds of 30 Mike-Mike.
Colt 1-2, SIF range control, you are cleared at entry alpha. You have the airspace from 500 to flight level 400. Weather is clear, visibility good in all quadrants. Authorize Colt 1-2 control.
Colt 1-2 confirms all altitudes, clear of clouds, bar deck 500. I have control. Let's review some information about the weapons you are using today. The AGM-65D Maverick is an infrared or IR precision-guided standoff air-to-ground missile with a 125-pound shaped warhead. It is best suited against armored, air defense, and fortified targets. This is a fire-and-forget weapon. Once launched, you can break off the attack and the missile will still guide to the target. Engagement range is restricted by seeker lock-on range, typically between 3 and 7 nautical miles. It is a good idea to use the Mavericks to eliminate any air defense units first from outside their weapon engagement zone. Up to 3 missiles can be loaded on the Lau 88 or single missile on the Lau 117. For IR Mavericks, if the target is hotter than the background, set the boat switch aft. If colder than the background, set the boat switch forward. At night, vegetation cools faster than metal objects, so the target should be hotter. In the morning, the vegetation heats up faster, so the target would be cooler. The AGM-65H Maverick is an electro-optical, precision-guided, standoff air-to-ground missile with a 125-pound shaped warhead. It is based on the AGM-65B version, but with a charge-coupled device, or CCD seeker, optimized for desert operations. It has an operational range greater than 12 nautical miles, but it's most effective between 3 and 7 nautical miles. Up to 3 missiles can be loaded on the Lau 88 or a single missile on the Lau 117. When launching, remember the 30-30-30 rule. 30 degrees of maximum bank at lock-on, 30 degrees per second roll rate at launch, and 30 degrees maximum bank angle change lock-on to launch. Minimum altitude for launch are 300 feet AGL for the EO version and 150 feet AGL for the IR version. Ensure a Maverick profile is selected and the MAV MFCD is set to SOI to prevent switch errors or a dry pass. The missile will not fire in sensor mode. Ensure the pointing cross is steady for at least 1 second before firing. A flashing pointing cross indicates that the missile may lose lock at or after launch. This could be caused by an insufficient temperature difference between the target and the background, target size is too small, or the seeker head exceeds launch angle criteria. If the target is locked but the cross is not steady, the missile may be out of gimbal limits. Fly towards the flashing cross to center the seeker and ensure a successful target track. The range will provide some illumination parachute flares for targets 2, 3, and 4. Call contact target, close spot, point 1-3. 2, contact armor target, close spot, point 1-3. You have permission to engage. If you cannot locate the targets, you are permitted to circle the target area and re-engage if required. Do not stray outside the target range or MOA. You are at the IP. You are cleared in hot.
Rifle.
Colt 1-2, tally. That's a kill. Let's move to the next target. Rifle. Colt 1-2, tally. That's a kill. Let's move to the next target.
One, tally. Rifle.
Colt 1, that's a kill.
Let's move to the next target. Contact, armored target, 11 o'clock, port 7. Colt 1-1,
tally.
Good pass. Re-engage. Good pass. Re-engage. Good pass. Re-engage. Colt 1-2, tally.
Guns, guns, guns!
Good pass. Re-engage.
Pull up.
Good pass. Re-engage.
Altitude. Good pass. Re-engage.
Guns.
Pull up.
Guns.
Good pass. Re-engage. Good pass. Re-engage.
Altitude. Good pass. Re-engage.
Pull up! Pull up! Pull up! Pull up! Pull up! Pull up!
Guns! Guns! Guns!
Good pass. Re-engage.
Pull up! Pull up!
Guns! Guns! Guns!
Good pass. Re-engage.
Pull up! Pull up! Pull up! Pull up!
Guns! Guns! Guns!
Pull up! Pull up! Altitude! Altitude! Pull up! Pull up!
Good pass. Re-engage.
Pull up! Pull up!
Guns! Guns! Guns!
Pull up!
Guns!
Pull
guns!
Up.
Guns!
Good pass. Re-engage. That's a kill. Time to egress. SIF Range Control, Colt 1-2, requesting clearance north of Exit Bravo.
Colt 1-2, SIF Range Control, cleared for Exit Bravo. Have a nice night.
Colt 1-2, roger, cleared for Exit Bravo. Colt 1-2, off, safe, visual. Colt 1-2.
Colt 1-1, off. Colt 1-1, fence out.
Colt 1-2, fenced out, 2-6. Hard deck restriction is terminated. You're permitted to land and shut down your bird. I'll give you a rating then.
Cavaletti, Colt 1-1, inbound.
Colt 1-1, Cavaletti, fly heading 169, Fort 1.
Colt 1-1, request landing.
Colt 1-1, Cavaletti, clear to land, runway 25.
Altitude.
Take the taxiway to the right. You can park in the first free revetment on your left.
Congratulations. You passed this PO. You received a qualified Q rating. Well done.